passes unanimously. Item number 19, county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, may we respectfully take 19 and 20 at the same time?
Please.
They are absolutely, basically identical. Well, they're identical annexations. Let me put the first one on the table for you. This is in your packet. These are requests for annexations from the City of Cumming. Let's take up the Northside Hospital one first. And Ms. Kim, in your packet, you'll see the actual annexation map. I'll put it out here for you, but it's in your packet as well, in color in your packet. The yellow is the city limits, all right? The areas in red are the portions to be annexed. They are contiguous. That's not the right one, Commissioner. That's my fault. I'm kind of maybe taking them in reverse order.
That's Ventura Park.
It's the hospital one, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. It's this one again. I'm sorry about that. You can see the number of parcels. There is contiguity as they knock off the various parcels being annexed. There will be contiguity. We have completed our five-day letter, which puts the city on notice of any county-owned infrastructure. There is no county-owned infrastructure within the property to be annexed. There is county-owned water and sewer infrastructure in the right-of-way next to it. All right, we put them on notice of that. But with respect to the actual zone or the annexation itself, let me go through the actual parcels. There are, I believe there's eight parcels. Yeah, there's eight parcels. It's 65.83 acres that they are seeking to annex. Most of the property is either agricultural or commercial business district, but on our future land use map, it is either commercial, high density residential, or neighborhood shopping or neighborhood commercial. We've checked with planning and development, and from an intensity of use and future land use perspective, what the City of Cumming is proposing, which is basically office and institutional, is consistent with where we were going to go as well. I've talked with our department directors, and quite frankly, Tim is here, and he's the one that's the most important with respect to whether or not we have the legal authority to object. In the annexation law, we have only a couple of reasons by which a county can object to an annexation, and that is typically whether or not, primary one is whether or not the proposed use of the property to be annexed is going to result in infrastructure overburden to us. In other words, we don't have the capability or resources to provide infrastructure to what it is they're proposing to do. Well, that's not the case here, and Tim can say that. In fact, we've got a little bit of an issue of whether we would like to provide infrastructure, water and sewer service to it or not, but it's not a matter that it's going to overload us.
It is our service area.
But the hospital tract's a bit unclear, the actual existing hospital parcel itself, so let's take that. So,
is it getting service bus down?
The hospital's the city. The board has made that clear in the past that the hospital would be served.
So we're not servicing now, even though it could
That's
be.
Correct. Well, the hospital, they had a line in that area already.
Yeah.
And so that part in that old road, horseshoe circle, you might remember, mm-hmm. they had a line in there. So that's clear that the city is these other tracks.
So who will service these other tracks?
That hadn't been
determined.
That's still up.
And right now, you know,
if it's in our area, why wouldn't it be us?
It probably would be, but there I know that the City of Cumming has an interest in perhaps swapping with the county with respect to some infrastructure service out on that Doc Sam's Road.
For our fire station
and perhaps allowing them to be able to
fire station for all that.
Also, they get cheaper water if they do it through the city.
Well,
I think we need to do an apples for apples trade. We always seem to go with short.
Well, it would make sense if the hospital expands. They don't want to separate
they
don't water.
No, they don't,
but maybe they could give us a little more than.
Well, to be fair, we don't know what's going to go here. I mean, what they've said in their application is this is going to be office and institutional use. I could see what professional office buildings for doctors next to the hospital.
Correct. Which is a big service.
On the new map,
we've always understood that the annexation doesn't really change the service delivery map, and so that's still the board will make those decisions and swaps. later, maybe on a parcel by parcel review.
But it's not a detriment to us, the city, the annexation.
Well, here's, right now, as y'all have noted, this is basically vacant land. Okay, there is, on their application, there is in fact, it will be used for hospital institutional, so it is gonna be a change in the use. My only point I'm making to you is though, is that the change of uses they're proposing are consistent with our future land use map. And we get.
There's no problem.
No problem.
They don't charge from city property tax, we don't, and we get the property tax on both.
Right.
Yeah.
Are you looking for a motion?
I am, and I think.
Both of them, just one?
Just this one for right now, the motion I would need is that the county will not interpose an objection with respect to this annexation.
So move.
Motion and second, any discussion?
Needs to be time sensitive.
Time sensitive, I'm sorry.
Need one more discussion?
No, good, your motion second, yes, sir.
We have a motion and second, we have a discussion.
What is there, does anybody know what the reason is for wanting to annex this?
Cheaper water.
Well, besides cheaper water.
You know, I don't know, you have in your package, you have the actual application for the property owner that has come forward seeking it.
Some people find it easier to work the city than the county.
Well, we're trying to work on that, I know you're right, for permitting and such. I mean, because obviously we lose all those permitting fees and impact fees and.
I don't know, and then they don't have, all they have an obligation to do is what they provided in this.
I'm just curious, someone on the county wanting to do some kind of big project, they know that.
Why don't they take, and it doesn't mean to object, it's just kind of a question, why wouldn't they take these other three parcels just to?
The property owner that made the application may not own them.
So they didn't ask for it?
Okay. Yeah, because this is being, this is property owner initiated, they've come to the city and asked.
Yeah, this definitely is something we're not bringing to this yet.
All right, I believe we have a motion and we have a second. Any further discussion? Not, please vote on the motion, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. There are none, that motion passes unanimously, item number 20, similar situation, council?
This is not. Yeah, I'm doing it personally, to try and mesh y'all as much as I can, yeah.
This is not.
Item number 19.
Next one is the Ventura Industrial Park tract, that is nine parcels. Y'all have the map in your folder, you should be able to see it, I've got them right here as well. That's on Pilgrim Mill, right across the street from the aquatic center. It's nine parcels, our zoning is CBD and M1 restricted, their proposed zoning is highway business and M1 restricted. Again, we've checked with planning and development and they have confirmed to us that from a land use perspective, there is no substantial realignment of land uses that is being.
Is it just the properties in red?
Yes.
Who serves, are we servicing those properties now, Tim?
No, sir, this is, this is totally City of Cumming service area on Antioch Road. We have some transmission lines through there, but no service.
Once again, it could be the property owners that just don't have made the application for that, let me see what it is.
John Kelly.
John Kelly? That's who's made the application to the city.
He and Fred. It's all, and if they owned the whole park at one time, they kept these and ran them out. Yeah, put the option there.
Again, let me just go through the criteria on how we can interpose an objection if there's a substantial change in the intensity of allowable use. There is a proposed use which significantly increases the net cost of infrastructure. Or if it defers substantially from our existing uses on our county's comprehensive land use plan. Again, everything we've seen shows that these are basically almost identical to what we have on our, the way it's up now versus what they propose to keep it. You will see the problem here from a connectivity standpoint or a contiguity standpoint that they are addressing that. That's really not an objection we can raise. They do need to address it, and they've indicated, I talked to their city attorney, indicated they are going to address it. So there's nothing we would worry about anyway, but they are going to take care of that issue.
All right. Is there a motion?
I need just a motion to interpose no objection.
So moved. A motion and a second. Any discussion? If not, please vote on the motion, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. There are none, that motion passes unanimously. Counselor, was that time sensitive?
It was too. Yeah, can the maker and the second just repeat?
Time sensitive.
Can the record reflect that?
Record should reflect that item number 19 is time sensitive.
Imagine if the city.
As is item number 20.
Imagine if the city ever imposes its own property tax, they probably wish they did.
So I'll tell you, we have, she's got to change dates in how long. You want to do these two first or not? Oh, I see what you're saying. All right, well, let's do that. We'll take a break and.